So a lot of the evidence that tells us about the brain plasticity actually comes from London and studies of black cab drivers. So black cabs are sort of a really good taxi service in London. And it turns out that to become a black cab driver, you have to study for between 2 and 4 years. And at the end of that time, you take a test, which is just beautifully called the knowledge. And to pass the knowledge, you have to memorize 25,000 streets and 20,000 landmarks in central London. The average amount of times it takes to pass the knowledge is 12 times. So it's a very demanding spatial training. And scientists studied the brains of these black cab drivers, and they found that at the end of this spatial training, the hippocampus in their brain had significantly grown. When they retire from being a taxi driver many years later, the hippocampus shrinks back down again. And the hippocampus is the area of the brain that specializes in acquiring and using spatial information. So nobody thought brains were this plastic, that the hippocampus could grow to use that spatial information and then shrink back down again. And it really caused scientists to have to rethink everything they knew about the brain and people's ability. Math classrooms tend to be set up to be all about numbers and speed and calculations. But recent brain evidence shows us that actually when people work with numbers, certain brain pathways light up. When they work with visual representations of those numbers, other brain pathways light up. And actually, when people are learning both visually and numerically together, both of the brain pathways light up and people learn more powerfully. So we can make all of math visual. The whole of the math curriculum should be about visual ideas that kids see and understand. And this new brain evidence that when you engage visually as well as numerically, brain crossing is going on and different brain pathways are lighting up is very powerful.